My enemies are at work. Joe Igbokwe cries out, denies attack. Joe Igbokwe, will I say that serves you right, or will I say you deserve it? You see, my viewers, Joe Igbokwe, as you all know, is one of the very Lagos State governor, Sanwo-Olu. You see, many a times Joe Igbokwe have been seen tackling, challenging, you know, saying negative things concerning the region that he belongs to. You know, just because of his position, using his position against his people. Wow. Even to the Biafrans, till this very moment, Joe Igbokwe is still very much criticizing them. You know, saying all sorts of things, you know, denying them. In fact, in this very broadcast, Joe Igbokwe raised an alarm, says his enemies are at work, that his vehicle wasn't attacked, because the information on the media made it clear that Joe Igbokwe vehicles was attacked. And we can even see that from the photo, how his vehicle was attacked. This is not a painted vehicle, for crying out loud. This is not a painted picture. This is a reality. It's clear. So why will he now be denying the fact that he was attacked? I think Joe Igbokwe is only trying to exonerate himself, because many a times he has been seen, you know, bragging on the media that no one can do anything to him, you know, that he's a freeborn and born to liberate. Can you imagine? Okay. Well, let's quickly look at what he meant by defending himself. The special advisor to the Lagos State Government on Environmental Cleansing and Protection, Honorable Joe Igbokwe, reacts after it was reported that he had been attacked by a group of angry youths. Reacting, Honorable Joe Igbokwe took to his social media handle, where he said such never happened, and asked members of the public to disregard such news, as, according to him, we are peddled by children of hate. It was a figment of the marginalization and imagination of the lost generation, who know nothing except how to tell outright lies, falsehoods, posting curiously trivials, calling other Nigerians names and sowing seeds of discord, he said. According to the elder's statement, he said, just ended a weekly meeting with his colleagues. I will continue to preach that Igbo must imbibe cultural competence and emotional intelligence in Nigeria. They must learn how to build bridges across Nigeria and not burning bridges. This is common sense, he said. You will never change. You know, sure, you've heard him. That's maybe one of the reasons why he was attacked. He will never change. With his big mouth and many hate speech that is coming out from him, he will never change. All right. If you keep denying, that is on cup of tea. Nigerians are not telling him to admit. Biafrans are not telling him to admit. Indigo are not telling him to admit. He is on his own. Oyolowa. That is what the Yorubas will always say. He knows that he will be a laughing stock. That is why he is trying to defend himself. What's the need of doing that? Nobody is interested in you. So, whether they do anything to you, it's your own cup of tea. That is what you invited to yourself. You called for it, and that is why it's coming to you. Okay, the only thing that I will advise you right from my channel here is walk your path straight, because your path is achieving ghettos. They are taking note of you. So if you like, keep on with the hate speech that you that you are used to. This that has just happened to you now is a clear message that they are watching you. You understand? It's a clear message and a clear picture that you are watched. So you must be careful. Alright, my dear viewers out there, with all that you have taken note of right now concerning Joey Bokwe, what do you think? What do you think? Please deem it fit to leave your comments below the comment section. Click on the subscription buttons as well as the bell buttons to get updated each time we upload any new videos. Thank you.